Hello and welcome to this video about the multi-tone measurement. In this video, I will explain the particularities of this kind of measurement and the different Klippel solutions provided for them. The R&D module MTON or multi-tone measurement module and the QC task MTD or multi-tone distortion task. First, I would like to introduce the targets that we can reach using a multi-tone measurement. It is a meaningful one-point measurement. So with a single measurement, we get all the distortion, the harmonic, intermodulation, and the Rub&Buzz together. The combination of all the distortions gives us a characteristic distortion curve, which can be considered an acoustic fingerprint of our DUT. In addition, we can measure the thermal and nonlinear compression and the transfer function, and we can use the multi-tone measurement to obtain a meaningful SPL max value. Furthermore, we can get comparable results in both R&D and production environments. And it is based in a well-defined stimulus compatible with industry standards. Thanks to the flexibility and the signal characteristics, the multi-tone measurements have a broad range of applications. It can be used with transducer, passive and active systems, wireless speakers, DSP or amplifiers. The core of the multi-tone measurement is the multi-tone stimulus. So which advantage does the multi-tone stimulus have? In comparison with the sine sweep is important, but it's insufficient to meet the targets. With a sine sweep, we only get the harmonic distortion. It's a transitory signal, so we only get one frequency at a time, and it's not possible to measure the intermodulation distortion. However, the multi-tone stimulus is a sparse broadband stimulus, which is similar to music, being possible to apply a spectral shaping according to program material. In addition, fundamental and distortion can be easily separate. And the multi-tone stimulus is a reproducible, mathematically well-defined stimulus. How does a multi-tone measurement work? In this slide, we can see the principle of a multi-tone measurement. First, the stimulus is defined. Since it is a sparse multi-tone complex signal, there are three basic parameters that have to be defined in addition to the signal shaping: the minimal frequency, the maximal frequency, and the frequency resolution, which means how many signal lines per octave will be placed. Once the stimulus is created, the measurement can be done by placing the microphone in the near field. From the measurement, we get the spectra of all the measured signals. These measured signals are primary data which require a post-processing to get the multi-tone results. Regarding the multi-tone measurement results, it's important to understand why do we need to perform this post-processing? Why cannot we process directly the spectrum of the measured signals? The spectrum of measured signals is difficult to interpret, since the resolution of the distortion is defined by the length of the fast Fourier transform. Therefore, the distortion level depends on the stimulus length. On the contrary, the multi-tone response are measured in the same bands, which is the measurement interpretation. Fundamental, multi-tone distortion, and noise floor share the same number of points, since multi-tone distortion and noise floor accumulate the energy in the same bands of the fundamental. Now we will perform our first multi-tone measurement. To do it, we will use the Klippel solution for R&D environment, the MTON module. In this case, we will perform a single R&D measurement. The target of this measurement is just to overview the basic MTON results. As application object, we will use a passive loudspeaker system. As measurement device, we will use the Klippel analyzer KO3 system. In this case, we will use the default configuration, which consists on the laser card, XLR card, and speaker card. And in addition, we will use the amplifier card. The amplifier card will feed the signal to the DUT through the speaker card. At the same time, microphone and laser signals will be captured by the laser card. It's important to note that this hardware setup is specially prepared for this application object, a passive loudspeaker system. However, the Klippel system is compatible with other setups, as for example, self-powered or wireless systems. To perform our demo measurements, we will use an empty DBLab database. First, we need to create a new object. In this object, we will add an MTON operation. Before we run the measurement, we can check in the property page of the setup of the measurement is correctly defined. In the stimulus page, we can see that our multitone signal will be defined between 20 and 20 kHz, using a relative resolution of 12 lines per octave, and a voltage of 0.3 volts. Regarding the inputs, we can check that all the inputs, voltage and current, displacement and input sensors are activated. Now we can run our measurement. In a first overview, we can see the spectra of all the measured signals at the bottom. Microphone signal, voltage, current, and displacement. Above we can see the summary window, the magnitudes of transfer function, and the multitone response and distortion. In this case, we will just analyze the most important results. The microphone signal spectrum corresponds with the raw data of our measurement. On the one hand, we have the fundamental lines, and on the other hand, we have the full resolution noise and distortion and noise floor. The multitone response corresponds with the processes data, where we can see the fundamental, the multitone distortion, and the noise floor. And the multitone distortion related to fundamental are obtained from the multitone response. In the summary window, we can see the most important measurement results values, the voltage of the stimulus and the SPL value captured by the microphone, in addition to other important parameters as the maximum peak displacement or the maximum distortion ratio. Due to the nature of the multitone stimulus stationary broadband signal, the multitone distortion is caused by multiple nonlinearities. For that reason, a correct interpretation of multitone distortion curve will give us a lot of information about our DUT. For example, at the low frequencies, we can see the distortion caused by the stiffness, KMS, and the distortion caused by the mechanical resistance, RMS. The force factor, BL, will generate distortion in the whole frequency range, while the inductance from both displacement and current are present from resonant frequency. Last, at the high frequency region, the combi region will introduce distortion. From fundamental and multitone distortion curves are the relative metrics calculated. The relative multitone distortion, RMD, is calculated as the spectral distance between the fundamental and the distortion curves. For this measurement, it's very important to measure the noise floor, since a low signal-to-noise ratio will perform a wrong interpretation of a relative multitone distortion. Additionally, the total multitone distortion ratio, TMDR, is the energetic ratio of the total distortion and the total signal. The relative metrics are independent of the microphone position and the room response, since they affect to the fundamental response and the absolute multitone distortion equally. As a consequence, a single near-field measurement is meaningful and enough in some applications. Now that we have seen all the characteristics and capabilities of a multitone measurement, I would like to introduce the dedicated Klippel solutions using this kind of measurement. First, I would like to talk about the MTON or the multitone measurement module, which is prepared and designed for R&D applications. This module is the module that we have used in our previous measurement. This module is characterized by a high flexibility, including variable test and cooling intervals. Moreover, it offers a stepping excitation and speaker protection based on compression, multitone distortion, and voice call temperature. In addition, it offers noise floor measurements, and it is a very valuable tool for writing max SPL according to the IEC standards and for benchmarking. Now, in our next demo, we will explore the explain capabilities of the MTON module. To do it, we will rate the UMAX and the SPL max values according to the standard IEC 62-68-21. This rating corresponds with the maximum input voltage and SPL value measured under certain limits of compression and multitone distortion selected to obtain a sufficient sound quality. To perform this measurement, we will apply a stepping excitation to our device under test up to the limits I rated. As application object, we will use the same passive loudspeaker system that we used in our previous measurement. To perform the stipit measurement, we will use one of the templates available at the MTON module operation. The main advantage of this kind of templates is that we can run our measurement by changing some few number of parameters. In this case, we will deactivate the zapping. We'll set as minimum voltage 0.3 volts, which is the voltage that we use in our previous measurement, and we will set as maximum voltage a higher value, 5 volts. Last, we will change our minimum frequency to 200, since we detect in our last measurement that the signal to noise ratio at lower frequencies was very low. Now we can run our measurement. After 20 measurements, we get our Umax and our SPL Max values. These values are available in the summary window. In this window, we get information about which limit was reached, in this case, the multiton distortion limit. In the results of last past measurements, we can see that our Umax before the limit was reached was 3 volts, and the SPL Max that we measured was 116.6 dB. If we check the compression of the transfer function, we can see that the actual compression of our system is far away from the compression limit, which is 3 dB. However, by the multiton distortion, we can see how the multiton distortion relative to the fundamental was higher, higher, and higher up to the limit was reached at 3.37 volts. In addition to the MTON measurement module, Klippel offers a different module for QC applications, the MTD or multiton distortion task. Both measurement modules have in common the same stimulus, which gives us the possibility to transfer the same multiton stimulus and, therefore, to verify the SPL max of our last measurement in our production. The MTD is implemented in the QC system, which is specially designed to perform an efficient end-of-line testing. We can verify the max SPL capabilities of our production by doing a single test. It is optimized to perform the measurement in the minimal time possible, so many DUTs can be tested in a short period. It can be integrated in an automated production. It shows clear verdicts after every single measurement. The measurement data is reduced, which makes easier the results storage. It is simple and easily traceable. In our next demo, we will verify the max SPL in our production line. To do it, we will use as a stimulus a multiton at the Umax value obtained from our R&D measurements. As measurement object, we will use again our passive loudspeaker system, but in this case, we will just measure the microphone. In order to avoid external noises, the measurement we will perform in a test enclosure. Before starting the test, I would like to introduce the Klippel QC Start tool. This tool is dedicated to create and manage the QC measurements of the Klippel system, including the access to hardware configuration, the calibration, and many more. Furthermore, in the QC Start tool, we can find many different test templates sorted according to the device under test, transducers, systems, and many more. Although the Klippel QC Start is the recommended tool to configure the end-of-line measurements, the QC operations can be created directly in DBLAB. In this case, we will create a new QC operation directly in our previous database in order to collect all the measurements together. To do it, we will use the available QC operation templates. And we will log into the operation. Once we are logged in our QC measurement, we just need to configure our multiton distortion task. First, I will configure the routing correctly. In this case, we are using the speaker 1 output. Next, I will configure our stimulus according to the last measurement performed with our MTON measurement. The minimal frequency was 200, and our Umax voltage was 3 volts. Since it is a QC measurement prepared to be applied at the end of line of our production, we need to define our limits. To do it, we need to measure a reference DUT. After measuring our reference speaker, we get automatically our limits. Now, this QC operation is prepared to be used in our end-of-line test. As we can see in the summary window, we have read a pass verdict. It was expected since I have measured the reference DUT again. In addition, we can see the SPL level and the total multitone distortion ratio. Regarding the result curves, we can see in the multitone response window the fundamental spectrum curve, and in the distortion window the relative multitone distortion and the relative noise floor. Before finishing this video, I would like to summarize the most important characteristics of the multitone stimulus and the measurements performed using this kind of signal. First, we have seen that the multitone stimulus is a flexible broadband stimulus which is similar to music. Moreover, all distortion, harmonic, intermodulation and Rub&Buzz are available by a single measurement. Thermal and nonlinear compression can be measured as well. Multitone relative metrics are insensitive against room reflections, so non-echo room is required to perform our measurement. And moreover, a meaningful one-point near field measurement is enough for some applications. The Klippel system offers two independent and compatible modules for both R&D and production environment applications, MTON and QCMTD. And last, the multitone measurement is compatible with IEC and CTA standards. If you would like to know more about the multitone measurements, you can find further information in the Klippel website. There you can find information about the different modules that we offer, application notes, web seminar, know-how posters, and publications. Thank you very much for watching and see you soon.